Hey everybody, let's play another game of Twilight Struggle against the AI. So we're going to create a game. I will be the Americans. I think I was the Russians last time, so I am going to play with the optional cards. As the Americans, no influence handicap. Let's get it going. Excuse me. All right, so we have the Marshall Plan, which is always nice to play. Although we also have containment. Do we want to play containment at this point, or should we hope to get containment back? We have Cambridge 5, Fidel is really in blockade. It would let us discard one of these, but then they'll just come back. I think that the right thing to do here is to play containment. Although we're placing influence first. So we'll go with a traditional setup here. Like that. Start it off. We'll play containment as our headlining card. Hopefully it'll come back soon and we'll get it again. Marshall Plan will hold off for a little bit. So I'm going to play that. As the Americans, we don't have to worry about defectors, which is a nice change of pace. After that, we'll probably play Fidel and realign him out of there. Maybe towards the end, we'll play blockade with Cambridge 5. He's going to advance on the space race, which the computer is very likely to do for whatever reason. Excuse me. So he's going to decide. He's probably not going to coup. The AI seems very unlikely to coup in these situations. He'll probably prove me wrong and coup Iran right now, but so far that's been my experience. He actually might do it now since he has the China card. And he coups the Philippines. The AI always coups the Philippines for no particular reason. Waste of the China card, in my opinion. So I'm kind of stuck here in terms of there's no good way for me to get the DEFCON level down. So I might as well spread into Asia to keep track of that. So we'll do that. We'll take these, probably take Iran. Now that we're in Pakistan, I think that's okay to do. We'll take Afghanistan for the bonus point being adjacent to them. Him cooing the Philippines make me think it's likely that he has the Asia card, but I'm not 100% sure. You can never really tell. I need him to take a battleground, basically, that's not Iraq, so that I can start doing things against him. Nuclear test ban. He puts a bunch of influence. He put it in Afghanistan, which was an interesting choice. We will play... I think we just keep the influence train going here. Take these back. Put one in here to start spreading. Maybe two to block him from coming in that way. Although I don't think it's necessary to block at that point. We will put one more... He's probably not going to coup over in Panama, so I'll put it into Malaysia, just kind of to cut him off a little bit, I think. That might have been wasteful, but we've cut off his easy access to Thailand. Probably once we figure out what he's doing, we can play blockade to get rid of it, burn through it. We'll be discarding the Cambridge 5 because we have the containment boost on it. Puts it into Iran. Alright, so we'll play some influence here. Do I go here to get some access? Egypt is dangerous at this point. I don't think I want to take... Well, maybe Jordan would be a good thing. I'll take Jordan to get the bonus against Israel for the Arab-Israeli war, and then we will put... into probably India actually is a safer coup, right? Because he's got double. He'd have to double three instead of Thailand, which is double two. I'm annoyed that he's not particularly anywhere that's coup worthy, right? I'm not missing anything. Nothing that's takeable. I could always coup these places but and never get anything out of it, but that doesn't seem to be the best way about things. Comic-Con. Alright, he took Iran, Pakistan. Should I just coup Pakistan? Is that the thing to do? my odds here? I got pretty good odds. There we go. Kicked him out of there, lowered DEFCON. So I would like to get DEFCON deck back down to the 2 so I know what's coming on the next turn. But we stopped him from spreading into Pakistan a little bit. A higher roll would have been nice. What are you going to do? Depending on what he does here, I'll probably play Blockade on my next card. 5-year plan. He's going to have to discard. He discards Asia Scoring. That's lucky for him. Good job by you, buddy. So he did have Asia Scoring, but he's played it effectively to get around it. Somewhat luckily, I suppose you could also say. Let's see what he does here. I'm actually not too sure what his priorities would be. Europe. Okay. He put a lot of influence into West Germany, which is annoying. What happens here? So I don't have any scoring cards, so I guess I'll trigger this. And I'll place influence, secure that again. I get the one more. Probably start Canada, I guess. I didn't play the Marshall Plan, so I can't do the sort of securing the twos down here, which is always a nice thing to do. He's probably going to play that for the event. He does. He actually made it into... I kind of want to just play the Fidel card. Then I'll realign him out of there, hopefully. There we go. It's good. And after that, I will realign... here? 40% chance. No change. Try it again. No change. Okay. Well, that was unfortunate. That's always the way realignments go, I think, in this case. So, we kicked him out of Central America, which is good for us. He's still in Asia. DEFCON goes back up to 5, because no one's really working on lowering it at this point. I will play... Do I blockade at this point to avoid... No, because I want the 1, because it's going to happen either way. Not great. I guess I do... I guess I do this. It's kind of a shitty headline card, but it's really the only thing I have. I didn't want to play the US-Japan Mutual Defense Pact because I kind of want the ops. I'd rather he played it, obviously. Please be something dumb. Not Suez or European Scoring. Are we both even, I think, for that? See if he decides to participate or boycott. Boycott is at lowest DEFCON, right? Yeah, and the sponsor can play a 4-ops card. And he wins. That's terrific. And we both have presents, so that's a wash. No scoring cards have been played yet. I would love to coup Thailand. That would be wonderful. See what he decides. I would coup Thailand with something like Warsaw Pact, I think. He couped Iran, and he took it from me. DEFCON's at 4. I will Warsaw Pact then, trigger the event, wait for him to see what he's going to do. Probably place influence, I would assume. It's always better than pulling away influence. Is that what it does? Removal. Oh yeah, or add 5. Adding 5 is always better, especially with destalinization, which we haven't seen yet, but it is possible that that would happen. We're going to coup here. There we go. That's good. DEFCON goes down to 3, which is more, not believable, but it's a better place to be at this point in the game. We've got Thailand. We're doing okay in Asia once we get India locked down, and maybe Burma for the protection against the Indo-Pakistani war. I would coup something, I think, here. Although there's nothing really. Alright, he's going to play Suez for just the ops. So we don't have a good place to coup, so I'm going to place influence. Do that to stop him leeching into India very efficiently. So we're in a good place here. Iran would be a wonderful place to coup, I think. Probably don't have great odds. would it be? Playing this digital game has actually made me forget what I would be, what my roles are and things. So it would be 4. So I'd need at least a 4 to roll, I think, to get it eliminated. He's gonna play that. Jordan? Interesting. He'll get another realignment roll. Jordan is not what I would have chosen to do. Well, oh, and Israel too. Well, all right, so that actually worked out very, very well for him. And that's extremely, extremely annoying. So we are kicked out of the Middle East. So, let's just play this, trigger the event, it failed. So now I can, do I want to just work back in? No, I can't even, no, I could put 2 into Iran. I think I'm better off just securing South Korea at this point. Maybe we've lost the Middle East. We'll need the, what are our card options to get in there? Nothing until the mid-war, really, right? I don't think so, because the USSR has the Egypt card first. We'd have to wait for, like... No, that doesn't even go into the Middle East. Is NATO in effect? No, it's not. We'll put it into... Canada? We haven't seen De Gaulle yet. Maybe NORAD will come out. Not a good start for us, though, at this point, really. South Africa is in trouble. I should probably start taking Botswana just to prevent realignment stuff from coming. And actually, yeah, he's gonna start moving up. I have to keep blockade. Maybe I'll just coup Lebanon, actually. That's probably the best thing to do. I'll do it with this, trigger the event. Attempt to coup Lebanon. There we go, that's good. Maybe that'll protect us a little bit. Drops the DEFCON down to 3. Or no, it didn't, because it's not a battleground. Sorry, it's at 3. But we're in there anyway. We can start building back up. If I could, I would coup again. I'd coup Syria, maybe. Just to... Arab-Israeli war, which is... he couped Lebanon, okay. I'm gonna coup him back. I'm going to trigger the event here. I have to be in here. It's unfortunate, but this is just the way it is. I would love to be able to get the DEFCON down. Nasser. He got me down in Lebanon, but I'm still there. Still fighting. So with this one, I would probably... Do I coup Iran? Or just place influence? I guess I just place influence. We have to hold Israel, I think, as the US, it's particularly important. USSR, I don't feel, needs to take Israel. It's maybe a benefit, but it's not something worth doing. It's kind of like Japan. It's kind of a lesser Japan. DEFCON goes up to 4. We got the Middle East and De Gaulle and CIA created, which is too bad. We have. This will be good to headline, though, at least. We could play blockade and get rid of destalinization. We're going to have to deal with decolonization and De Gaulle at that point. Indo-Pakistani war. I think we're in okay shape, depending on what we get here. Burma would have been nice to take. He's probably going to go for Pakistan, I would assume. And we have control of Afghanistan and India, so his role shouldn't be great. Maybe 1 out of 5 or something? I forget what the actual math is. India, and he succeeds. Terrific. Alright. Oh, and he goes again, of course. Alright, so we need to start working to take the Koreas or something. Japan would be nice to have. NATO is now in effect, which is good. That'll make the UK card a little bit better, and it makes other things. I think there's other cards that are affected by NATO. The NATO card is gone, obviously, with the 4 ops, though, which is always a problem. There's no uncontrolled countries that I'd want to get rid of. So what do I want to do? Blockade, I guess, and just get rid of it. Destalinization. And with this one, we are going to attempt a coup. Actually, no. No, I just want to place influence in Israel, right? What happened? Play this again. Trigger the event. Get rid of that. Place influence into Israel. Take control of it again. Yeah, the AI actually has us our backs up against the wall here a little bit. Not in great shape. That military with the war in India was unexpected and disappointing. That's why you always have to move into Burma, I think. Pakistan's a little bit more protected, generally. China card coming back to us. He breaks control of a couple places. Trigger this event. We're gonna place influence, take back Korea, take back Pakistan. And Egypt, what happened to that card? He played it, got discarded, I think. Maybe I'll start going in here. I can eventually take France, I think, because I have Truman Doctrine. He's going to be 1 point up on me in the Middle East scoring at this point. No, he's 3. Oh, he's domination. Of course he does. 2 battlegrounds to my 1. So I'll probably space race the... All right, we got a victory point. Always nice. We'll probably space race decolonization, play this for ops the CIA created, and then play Truman Doctrine if possible. Although it won't even be really all that useful at this point. Maybe I can headline it next time on France. What did he do? He couped Pakistan. Terrific. I should probably coup Pakistan? Take some back. What would be my odds here? Oh, I can't. He's down to 3 anyway. I guess I'll attempt a coup. Syria. Alright, it failed. Which is annoying. That was probably a terrible, terrible play. We should have just couped Iran or something like that. Now we have 2 action rounds left, so we'll have to play Middle East and Space Race Decolonization. And I'm losing ground in the ability to keep pressure on him. Oh, nice, he plays that for us. Take another battleground in Asia. We have to deal with Pakistan. It's very problematic. Realignment roles would be maybe useful. If the DEFCON does not drop, then he puts 2 into Japan to take it from me, just to be a dick. Middle East, he gets 3 points. He's up 9. We're gonna have to space race decolonization next, and then just kind of hope for good things to take control of France and just start that process. I'm worried about Africa too, because he hasn't moved into Botswana yet, but the last game I played against him, realignment was devastating, and he takes Pakistan. All right, well, I'm gonna space race this. It fails. He's gonna play Asia scoring, which evened us out because he took back Pakistan. Which is incredibly annoying. I have to play Truman. I guess I didn't have the China card. What did I do? I must have done something. I wasted it around. That was silly on my part, to say the least. There's no point in France because they can just come in through there. So I guess I have to coup with this. Coup Iran. Doesn't do anything. DEFCON drops, at least. It'll go up to just the Middle East for him to be able to coup. We didn't lose any victory points because of the military operations either. Well, that was really devastating. I was just talking out my ass about what I was going to do with the Truman card, and then it all just went away. Alright, this hand is a little bit better. It's clearly better. Do I play NORAD? Probably. It seems useful at this point. Although if he has Quagmire, it's Well, for not. Because this ends with Quagmire, right? Canceled there. Yeah, NORAD would be great, except if... There's always the potential that Quagmire comes out early, and it's very upsetting. All right. NORAD is in effect. It's gonna remove me from France, I would assume. France and Germany would be my guesses. What did he do? He didn't do France, he just did Germany. Germany, UK, and Canada. Wow. Wow, what an annoying thing. He better coup to take advantage of doing that. If not, shuttle diplomacy. Middle East or Asia. Subtract one battleground from USSR total. Yeah, that would have been good last time. I'm concerned about what he's going to do if he puts them into Germany. Panama. He coups Panama. Alright, so he got in there. DEFCON dropped. Not Israel, though, right? No, and not Lebanon. So those are my two safe countries, so I'll just trigger that. Place influence here, here, here. And we've got to start going somewhere. Maybe Japan is such a waste. Maybe I'll take... it's just kind of silly. Algeria, I guess? Start spreading that way. OAS founded, two influence in Central America and or South America. SALT improves DEFCON. Coup modifiers are down. Summit is a stupid, useless card. Brush war. Could I brush war? I could brush war Pakistan. Alright, he's spreading. Let's play the event. Pakistan. I have a 33 chance to succeed. Not great. Is there anywhere better? Panama? 50%. That's better. And it fails. So, that's terrific. Great job by you. Africa scoring is bad. Salt. I'll probably play Salt and put them in to take some Africa scoring and then play the scoring card. Independent Reds, we'll play that in Romania, as is our want. Romania gets the extra bonus point if we actually manage to take control of it somehow, but Truman is gone. After all, well, it could come back, but it's not here right now. And at that point, taking France is probably the better option. Alright, he puts a bunch into France. So I'll place influence, I'll put one there, that. And tricky. What do I want to do? I don't really know what I want to do here. Maybe Turkey? Just get some low European foundations going on. I could play the China card in Asia, which would be nice. Gonna take back Pakistan. We'll have to start doing that at some point. South African unrest. Probably play. Oh, you didn't play the event, actually. So I'm going to place some influence with this. Two there. Three more. Three more is not particularly interesting. I could take Taiwan. I have two if I go out of here. I was putting South Africa and take South Africa. I do have to play the African scoring card at some point, so I might as well just start considering that right now. Because what is the... Is a split? I'm up by two there. Which is good. OAS is not... Maybe play OAS down here to start getting in. He space raced that. I thought he played it, but he space raced it properly. I'm gonna play the event for this one, go into Argentina, take control of it. The U.S. can easily get into Cuba and Mexico, so that's not a huge concern for me. I might hold on to this card, see what happens next time. Because I will have to play the scoring card on the next turn. Do I have a lot of cards? It's hard to tell. Oh, I have two turns left. So I get two influence and two victory points, which is nice. They have to go in the same country. That's fine. Happy with France. Such a great card. If you have NATO in effect, that is a fantastic, fantastic card. All right, so France is annoyingly locked up for a little bit. We can put two influence in there. He's going to put two influence in instead. Do I want to do puppet governments at this point? Contain no influence from either country. It's not really worth it at this point. I'll probably just place influence. I'll go into Mexico to get a presence going there. And we have to play the scoring card this round. He plays Europe scoring. It's tied. Yeah, it's tied. It's fine. And I'm going to waste my turn, lose a couple points playing Africa scoring. Oh no, we're tied. Oh, we both have two battlegrounds, that's right. Always forgetting. Always forgetting the battlegrounds. That was good. We kind of treaded water for a little bit. But we do have Ask What You Can Do For Your Country. Again, not a hand that I particularly want to play it with, though. So, Panama Canal Returned, I think, is the proper headline here. It's always a great headline. One op card, but you get three influence in three countries, including Venezuela and Panama. It doesn't break Panama control, unfortunately. He saw through that. He knew it was coming. After that, I probably could have done We Would Bury You Too to prevent his coup ability. So he takes control of Egypt. Hopefully he does not coup, so we can just play this. I don't have UN intervention, so it's too bad. Three victory points is a lot. It doesn't seem like a lot, but once you're actually in a position like this where you could jump from 7 to 10, it's not particularly great. Or at least negates 3 points off of our scoring. China card. So I will trigger this event. DEFCON is at 2. I am going to realign. That is terrible realignment odds. So I'm going to... I guess I'll place some influence. I trigger this event. Yeah, that's right. DEFCON will go there. I'm going to place some influence. There. And... two more influence. I feel like I should tie up France or something. Because over here, nothing is really happening. There's nowhere I can put in to really go anywhere. Chile feels like a waste a little bit. Maybe I'll break control of Panama. That doesn't really... well, maybe Cuba. It's probably the best option. Put it into Cuba. Take control. That was no red coming through for us. So we're in okay shape in Central America. South America is wide open. The other scorings are gone. Southeast scoring is still out there. So those are the two that are left. So the Americas and Southeast scoring. Che, he's probably going to play the card. Failed in Costa Rica. Well, what a terrible decision to do that in Costa Rica. Is that the only place you could do it? Yeah, probably. I would love to space race that. I am going to place influence with this card. I will probably... could take Romania. Is that worth it? Taking Pakistan would be nice too. He's done a good job there. Do I need to start going into Burma as well? This is a real clusterfuck over here, kind of. I think what I'm going to do is take Chile. He has Allende, or Allende, however you pronounce it. But maybe I can boost it up a little bit. That adds 2 influence in Chile, I think. So we'll see. Not sure exactly what... This is tough. I've usually done a much better job of keeping him out of the Americas. Ooh, he took that. That's really annoying. I will... He's in France, so he has a slight point advantage in France. I should have done better than that. I'm not really playing particularly well here. What I think I need to do is... could do that. I could realign and do it in Panama, maybe. Let's play the event. Put that, and then I'm going to realign this here. Come on, no USSR. Oh, god damn it. So that didn't do anything. I guess I'll try it again. It's not great odds. Alright, we're just out of Panama. I really hate realignments so much. That was terrible. I don't know where else I should have... what else should I have done? It was too good. I guess Brazil wasn't really a great option either. Venezuela, he's kind of locked in there. What are you going to do? Play the event? Okay, he does. I'm fine with that. And you get a one-up card. He knows I have Bear Trap. Depending on what he does, I might play Bear Trap. Yeah, leave Costa Rica alone. Leave it alone. Play the event. Playing a little loose here, I think, but we'll see. Maybe he'll waste a turn. Just waste one turn. It makes it so worth it if you just waste one turn. Have only Soviet cards and have to throw them all away, because you must have a lot of Soviet cards, because I have not seen any. Come on. Good luck to me. No, grain sale to Soviets. But he failed, at least. That's good. I'm going to space race this guy. Success. Gain a victory point. Bump up on the space race. He's got a similar dilemma about what he wants to do. Hopefully he'll fail again, or he'll get rid of a devastating Soviet card. Come on. I think the AI's improved, though. I don't know if they've made any changes. There have been a couple patches. Success. He gets rid of Camp David. He's got all these American cards. Okay. I'll play Olympic Games. What will I do with it? Maybe... Just terrible spot here. Maybe I'll just... I need to put him in a position that is difficult. I guess I should protect Chile, right? There we go. Just in case Allende comes out. Was it remove? Or it just adds 2 USSR influence, I think. You don't remove a US influence, if I'm remembering correctly. How many points is that? 4 points. Terrific. I have to play Summit, so I'm going to attempt a coup in here. Okay, does nothing. Very useless. I lost a victory point. Not in good shape here. Not in good shape at all. Give me a ton of Soviet cards so I can headline this thing. That's a pretty good one to headline, I think. Or this. This would actually be devastating. I think I'll do that. I'll headline that. Could be devastating for him. So battleground countries, I can coup at will. Does not affect DEFCON. I didn't realize until the digital version how good of a card this is. It's really a fantastic headline. Southeast scoring, I think I'm tied, maybe? No, he's up one. Ugh. Alright, well, we'll see what he does. We'll do a couple coups. See how things go. Start with Venezuela, I think. What is this? If US has it, claim it face up. Okay. I might coup with a China card. Yeah, I'm gonna coup with the China card. Venezuela. Okay, that was horrific. Oh, it doesn't even lower it until that point. That's interesting, right? Of course, that's obviously, that would be true. But he needs to coup somewhere to get it down to two to make it not worthwhile. Or to make it worthwhile. Flower power. Ugh, that's so annoying. I'm going to attempt to coup again. There we go. Get him out of Venezuela. We could do it in Argentina next. With missile envy, because we don't really need that big of a roll to kick him out of there unless he continues to stay there. Cambridge 5. He's trying to coup Mexico, but he failed. He drops it down to 2, which is ideal for us. Alright. I get to place an influence. I'll actually just do that, I think. I'm gonna do this and then coup with it. Come on, there we go. That's huge. Now I can play South American scoring. We have control. That was a pretty decent turn of events, if I do say so myself. Maybe I'd coup Panama, just to see if anything can happen. Taiwan's a battleground now. I'm not too worried with that yet. So what do I have here? I get 7 points or something? 8 points. I'll definitely be playing South American scoring on my next card, unless I can coup his... Uruguay, he took out Costa Rica. Ugh. Realignments always work for him. Never for me. I might coup Uruguay first. Maybe that makes sense. I could do it with South Africa. What is the Portuguese Empire crumbles? Southeast African states in Angola. I think I'd do that. So I'm going to trigger the event. I'll attempt a coup because the event doesn't really hurt us all that bad. Take him out a little bit. Make him waste time putting stuff in if that's what he's going to do. Otherwise, that gained us a sweet 2 points. Another hand that I couldn't really play, ask not what your country can do for you. Alright. We claim the China card. Face up? We do claim it face up. That's too bad. The other effect is much better. If US already has it, you add 4 influence in Asia, no more than 2 per country. That's something I'd prefer anyway, I think. Or generally prefer to have that as my action. Yeah, he's gonna do that. Okay, that makes sense. So I'm just going to play South America scoring. Get 8 points, not have to worry about it for a little bit. He had to waste a turn doing that. Probably coup Panama with the China card. Seems like a good idea. African or Southeast Asia countries. Here. Here. Can't do that. Can't do India, even though it looked... Oh, it's just me hovering over it. Laos, Cambodia. Has he already played the Southeast scoring card? No. Right? I feel like he had. Am I just losing my mind? Maybe it would be in the removed cards. Yes, it is. Okay, he did play it. Nigeria. I could coup Zaire. I'm still under the effect of that, right? That is this turn? Yeah, nuclear subs. I could start taking back some of Africa. Could do... Okay, he's moving into... There and there. I will coup. I will coup Zaire. Ugh, god damn it. Okay, well, at least he's out of there. Not a great roll, though. Coup Angola? I could. I don't really want to, though. Arab-Israeli War is under Camp David, so it's just... I thought the effect... Oh, he discarded it, right? He didn't play it, but it failed anyway. This is our last action round. Yes. I feel like I have a lot of cards. So I'm going to do this and attempt to coup in Angola. There we go, that's good. Good use of nuclear subs, if I do say so myself.
For the first time,
we almost have African domination. Is there a reshuffle happening here? DEFCON gets bumped up. Central American scoring.
The times are on the side of peace.
What can I do? This is another great hand for me. So, I guess our man in Tehran. I have nothing else that's really very good in that situation. Willie Brand, I'm not scared of. Quagmire, I'll have to deal with eventually. He's gonna play Comic-Con, which is not a very good use of that card, I don't think at this point. I guess just bumping up and protecting these countries. East Germany and Poland, but he didn't even do that. Although he's still thinking. He's gonna put a lot of thought into this Comic-Con event. He's probably got a lot of Soviet cards, you'd have to think. He protected East Germany a little bit more. Reshuffle. So this, discard it. This is just stupid, so I'll discard it. And the rest of it's fine. Interesting, not a lot of Soviet cards. Yeah, I confirm. Excuse me. That's terrible. I need to take Japan back. I've been ignoring Japan. The AI goes after Japan, and as a person who's used to playing against real people, you don't expect it. Coups Lebanon, but doesn't get much out of it. I should coup Panama, I think. With the China card. Come on. Oh, god damn it. Ugh. I have not been rolling well. Very, very annoying. Can place one influence. South Africa. Why not? Take control of Africa. Because we are, what, turn 7, so the next turn is the late war, so we're getting late war cards, so I can probably safely discard things. I might play not what you can for your country. I receive the China card. He's just very fond of giving me that China card. Face down, though. The Nixon plays the China card is a great card when you are the Americans and you have the China card, because you can play the China card and then immediately get it back on your next turn. Typically do it at the end, do it as like the US, Algeria. Terrific. He's got another realignment. Influence on West Germany. I'll probably spend the next turn putting down a bunch of... putting down a bunch of influence, I think. I have to fix what he did there. Two more influence. Oh, I was like, why can't I go into Panama? Of course I can't go into Panama. Here, I guess. And... nowhere else really scares me that I'd want to put influence in. Maybe Turkey. Take control of Turkey. Because I think what is happening here, we're very close to each other. Taking back France is kind of a priority. Willy Brandt will play into East Germany just to get rid of it, to put the influence in there to protect it. Is what it just adds one. Yeah. UN intervention with Voice of America. That sucks. Good play by him, though, and he just sticks it over there. All right, Willy Brandt, we will place influence first. We'll put it into West Germany and Japan. And then he gets to put his things down. It's fine. Just kind of holding. I cannot coup Panama, so I need to take one of the minor areas here. Maybe overprotect Guatemala, maybe, because, well, that doesn't even matter for realignment. Sadat expels the Soviets. So that's good. We could take Egypt and Libya, actually, with a 3-ops card. He's only got 1-op to do something with here. He's just taking a long time. Taking his sweet, sweet time. No change. He's going to try to realign. He failed because he sucks. And I'm going to play some influence here. Take Libya. Put us on a decent footing in the Middle East, at least. Don't want to go into... I guess you could go into Lebanon at this point, but you don't really feel like it's necessary. Pope John Paul. Oh, he space raced it. Interesting. I suppose that's the better thing to do, but I was not expecting it. So... I'm gonna play this and play some influence here. Just so he can't coup me out of everywhere on the next turn. And then I will put one in two. What is Europe? Maybe Europe. I might need to focus on. I'll put it into Romania. Maybe I'll take Romania. It would be a good bonus to take from him. USSR. So we have two more turns with which we can do things. I might Quagmire to keep Astronaut. I might Space Race Quagmire and then play Central America scoring. Yeah, so it's just two influence in Chile. And he does nothing. He failed with that too. So a lot of failed turns. So before he... well, I'm going to space race this. Failed. That's fine. So this is the last turn. I'll have to play Central America after this. Plays Marshall Plan. This is going to let me do it first. So here... oh, it's uncontrolled countries, isn't it? So I'll just beef up some security around here. Canada, just for the hell of it, and... Turkey? Why not? Just lock down the countries that we actually have. What did he do? Did he go into South Africa? No, what the hell did he do with it? Zaire and Botswana. Oh, he took Zaire, I think, or did something like that. I have to play Central America scoring. 3 points. Going into the late war. Get some late war cards out. Hopefully play Ask Not if we have a terrible hand. DEFCON goes up. It's not a terrible hand. We haven't had a terrible hand in a long, long time. You're up. He's up by one. What does this do? It's not worth playing that yet. I'll play grain sales. We have another great socialist government, so I could just... Well, maybe this will be the turn where I play Asnot, but it won't be for... it won't be a headline, certainly. Not particularly devastating. So... Oh, that's his headline. I'm sorry. I was trying to figure out what was going on, if how I was going to play that. He gains victory points and removes one influence from three countries in Western Europe. So it's good that we had the Marshall Plan just then, because it boosted up all our countries that he can really have any kind of impact on. So I'm not too scared about what he's going to do. Took it out of Italy. Yep, we will play Solidarity. Did he... Oh, he space raced John Paul. I'll attempt a coup with it then. We're gonna coup Zaire. There we go. That's what I like to see. That's too bad. You hardly ever see Solidarity get played as a card. We reduced the DEFCON though, so that's good. Europe is still up for grabs at this point. The Middle East is as well. Chernobyl. I don't have any scoring cards, so that's not... Well... What did he do with it? To an Angola. Huh. Am I behind on the space race? I'm not. Wow. All right. Well, I have to play that event. We're going to realign here. Come on. 8.3%. There we go. That's good. This one again. Take France. Germany. Oh. So they took that back, which is disappointing. But we got France. So we are up in my book. Slightly. We have domination, which is good. Maybe we'll take Romania. So it worked out pretty well. I play the scoring card next. Salt negotiations. He takes fucking France back. Alright. We're just gonna place influence with this. We'll take back France. And... maybe Lebanon? Just in case the scoring card comes out. After that, we don't have a lot of great options. We do have to play the scoring card at some point. Hopefully he won't be obsessed with France and just keep going after France. That tear down that wall is such a great card. I have no influence from either power. Here. Here. Here, just for realignment protection. Puppet governments. So I think we're in good space here. We've swung back. We're doing okay. There's nothing particularly wrong with what we got going on here. He put influence into South America. I'm going to place influence and take it back from him there. And one into Saudi Arabia. This is the time to just kind of hold on. So we're doing well. The blue bar is up in these three here. It's really just Asia is breaking even. So I think we're in pretty good shape. It might just be a ride it out to the end kind of game. Camp David, he gets played. I get a victory point and a bunch of influence. Middle East is looking good for us now too, which is A very nice situation to be in when you're the Americans. I think it's the only region on the board that's actually tilted towards the Soviets in sort of a very distinct, obvious way. Do I realign? I could. I'll realign with the China card. Here. Try it again. Okay, try it again. There we go, take control of that, and try it here. Come on. Oh, scumbags. Not a great turnaround, a very low impact take there for us. But we'll focus on Argentina. There's still 7 turns in this? Yeah, 7 action rounds. Colonial rearguard, African or Southeast Asian countries. Here. 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 And protect Algeria, I suppose. All the American cards are coming. I feel like the game has only been American cards. We've had such a good game that I can't even play Ask What Your Country Can Do For You. I think that's how you know you've had a good string of luck when you've had that card in your hand for a couple of rounds. Alright, I'll play European scoring. Get the points. I could play Ask Not at this point. Or, well, it's probably better to hold on to it again, right? And just space race one of these stupid things? When do socialist governments not happen? When Thatcher gets played, right? Oh, that would have been a great one to have. So I have 2 action rounds. So I'm going to space race this. Failed, but whatever. Not a great space race game this one's been. CIA created. Is he just gonna, he's gonna give me the game? Is that it? Is that how it's gonna end? He just gives up. West, against all odds, triumphs over the socialist forces of Alpha Struggle. That was not very good AI play right there. It had the CIA card. I apparently couldn't do anything with it. I'll have to look back and remember what actually happened. I'm sure it could have got rid of it at some points, unless I lowered DEFCON very early, which might have been the case. I don't know. Anyway, guys, thanks very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time.